This is just a short kind of talk about my own experience of late. Anything I tend to speak about or pass on to other people, I've gone through it, you know, to a quite an extreme degree myself. And that's across the board, you know, that I can't be kind of teaching anything or passing on anything to people unless I've been against the fucking wall with whatever I'm speaking about. So it's not fluffy things that I read in the book or that I had a brief idea about. I'm living it. I am it. And I don't say that as a boast. I kind of prefer if I wasn't at times, you know. So anyway, it's about following our own path. And it's very important for people listening to this, for those people who are on a path that maybe they resonate with what I'm saying. So as I've said before, I don't feel what I speak about or my journey is relevant to 6 billion people. I feel there are individuals, I don't know what number that could be, it could be 20, you know, it might be 20 because not many people listen to my videos. Maybe it is only 20. But there could be more, there could be 21. And it's about honouring our own journey, honouring what we say and what comes through us. And that's quite a difficult place to be as we move along. Now, in the day-to-day, obviously, we have social pressures, we have family who might question and kind of think, you're meditating? You're going to an ayahuasca ceremony? You're taking hallucinogenic drugs? You know, you're doing this? You're talking to dragons? All that kind of stuff. That's kind of easy. As we carry along, move along the path, obviously, we make connections with people. You know, and for myself, what seems to happen is that I dip in and out of people's lives, or they dip in and out of mine. You know, that we're on the frequency for a while and we're in tune with each other, and then we drop off. There's no frequency, or there's no, you know, there's no work together, there's no purpose. And then we come back and then we might go away. The point of all that for me, or what a big part of why I'm learning this, is for me to be rock solid, immovable. These were the words I was given, you know, in a ceremony 2.5 years ago. My initiation under our mother goddess was to be immovable when working with women, because obviously when you're working with people, they can consciously or unconsciously not want to do the work, not want to go to the shadow, not want to face their darkness because it's uncomfortable. They want a kind of easy path. So it's to not allow that and to not be seduced, not be kind of distracted or whatever it is, whatever techniques, intellect, information, arguing, all that kind of stuff. I don't have time for that. So, but it's also to be centered and rooted regardless of what's happening around us. And I mean, if you look at the life of Christ, how do you be centered and rooted when they're coming after you and when they fucking nail you to a cross? But he had the ability to do that. So it's about being present and honoring our journey. And I've had it's increasing experiences where people around me are important people, you know, people who I respect, shamans that I work with, people who I go to at times for kind of guidance or just kind of feedback. And I'd feel that they just have a different interpretation or a different journey. So what do? Do I listen to this wise person who I give them my power and I think, oh, he knows more than me. He's been doing this for a long time. Or do I look within and be present within myself and feel what feels right for me? And it might feel that I have to do completely the opposite of what this wise old person says, or this best friend or whoever, and think, no, I have to honor me and I have to stand, you know, face the fire of maybe being cut off, disliked, ridiculed. Because that's all my own ego, my own fear of not being loved, not being liked, not being accepted. Oh, I'm alone again. Oh, nobody loves me. All that kind of stuff. And that's the path. Because it's so tempting. If I could just have one person who likes me, thinks I'm funny and says, yeah, you're doing great, Gavin. You're really spiritual. You're on the right path. Is that, am I kind of playing to the crowd there? Am I just looking to be liked? Or can I really honour what's coming through me? You know, that's been my journey over the last few months. At times to lose people from my life and let them lost, you know, let them go and think, I am more important than this relationship or this person. Now, there's discernment needed in this, to feel what's, you know, what's important. If you argue with your kids, they're 3 years of age, it might not be best to cut them off and say, no, I'm more important. Go out in the world and fend for yourself. But that's the ongoing relationship with self or with our own being, to honour what's coming through us and to stand in the face of that potential adversity and think, you know, for example, for me, part of that fear was around the videos I've done talking about sex. So, and there's more of that to come. Ha! Pun intended, maybe. I don't know. So, but it's too, because it rocks people. And it rocks me. And that's why I talk about it. That's why I want to go there. And isn't that brilliant that we're challenged? We get out of our comfort zones of fluffy sexuality and fluffy spirituality. And we get into all the nasty, dirty, confusing stuff. And we have to kind of explore that confusing stuff before we find our feet. That's the whole point. You know, wouldn't it be wonderful if we all kind of knew, I know what my next step is. It feels right. But sometimes we don't know what the next step is. We don't know what feels right. You just have to take a step. You have to go out there and you have to try something different, maybe a few times. And other people might be looking at you thinking, why are you doing that? And you might be thinking, why am I doing this? I don't know if this is the right thing to do. And then a little bit down the road, you might think, this was so the right thing to do. Or you might think, no, I've learned something from it, but I'm going to move on. I'm not going to do that anymore. And that takes courage. That takes your own inner strength to follow and honour our own path as opposed to what society might say, or more so, as opposed to what our own mind is kind of afraid of facing. It's good to get into the unknown. You know, it's good to not know. It's good to be confused. It's good to be unsure, to go into those places and explore. And maybe like people might be listening to my videos going, why is he going doing these? He's just gone off track. Why is he? He's no longer spiritual. But maybe there's some work in there for me. Maybe there's some exploration to kind of find my footing. And I might just take one little gem of wisdom and experience back from all that madness and think, oh, well, it was worth it because I learned this. Isn't that great? But we're so busy judging everyone else and each other and saying, oh, he shouldn't be doing this. She's not spiritual at all. Sure, they don't have coloured yoga mats. They don't have enough crystals. You know, she only has 56 tarot decks, you know, and she doesn't know what the alchemist is. I don't know. I don't know anything about tarot. Anyway, so yeah, honour your path and your journey. And who gives a fuck about other people, ultimately? Once you're not out there killing people, I think we're doing all right. So, yeah, thanks for listening. I don't know if that made any sense to anyone. Maybe it was just me. But enjoy your day. Thanks, bye.